Hi, good day to you. Without further ado, let's get started. Let's move on to experimental techniques and measurements. So you'll be exposed to a wide variety of tools and equipment that is used to quantify a variety of characteristics. So for example, measuring mass, you use a tool called the balance. You can use the beam balance, the electronic balance, and for time, usually it'll be things like stopwatch. And in modern times, just for exposure sake, usually what I like to tell my students is, this day and age, we usually use a lot of videoing because using stopwatch, there's such thing called the experimental error of reaction time. Sometimes you have slower reactions, sometimes you have faster reactions. That's why it is encouraged to take many readings of the same experiment so that you minimize human error. Measuring temperature, use all kinds of thermometers. And yes, for this, in this day and age, a lot of outdated tools are being shown to you, especially in the chapter for pH, and that's fine. It's for exposure, it's for education. In modern times, we will use data logger in the lab. Measuring volume, there's a wide variety of containment vessels, pipette, burette. These are the more interesting sounding ones. That's why I want to introduce them to you first. For pipette, its job is to pick up accurate amounts of water. Okay, the burette, its job is to release accurate amounts of water. And in secondary school, the pipette that you are exposed to will be calibrated to fix volumes of like 20.0, 21.0, or 25.0. And for the burette, it has an accuracy to the nearest 0.05. So how this works is you fill it up to the top. At the top of the burette, there's a zero marking, means you have released 0 cm³ of liquid. So as you release, the liquid falls and the meniscus at the final point will show you how much liquid you have released. And just a personal preference, if your school's lab has the clipped one, the metal clip, instead of the turn handle faucet type, the clipped one works better. There's more control, although it's a little bit old fashioned. For measuring cylinder, simple, it's just to measure volumes of water, volumes of liquid accurately. For the conical flask and the beaker, for the conical flask, it's designed like that for swirling purposes, for users to mix liquids, to swirl. For beaker, it's for temporary storage on the bench and for future transfer. That's why there's a little beak at the top for easy pouring. Reading volume of liquid, look at the meniscus. For adhesive liquids, adhesive means the liquid tends to stick to other materials. So like water, the liquid water tends to stick to the walls of the containment vessel. For things like mercury is a cohesive liquid. It tends to stick towards itself, so it has a N-shaped meniscus as compared to the U-shaped meniscus of liquid. So you read the volume at the top of the meniscus. Okay, lastly, measuring volumes of gases. We'll talk about the gas syringe. This is how it looks like. You need to know how to draw it, and simple tubing and rubber bungs to connect to your apparatus. And talking about the SI unit, so it's SI stands for Standard International, so it's a sort of a common language agreed amongst scientists all over the world that this is the standard value for a certain characteristics. This as shown is something like currency. Like you state the value of something in today's context, usually towards the US dollar. So it's like to communicate the value of a certain characteristics easily. And collecting gases, there are three methods. Displacement of water, usually for gases that are not soluble in water. Downward delivery for gases that are more dense than air, so it will sink. Upward delivery is for gases that are less dense than air, so it will float. So this is a table for the gases. You do not have to memorize them. So questions we'd like to ask you, for example, in ammonia. Okay, ammonia is a very basic gas. It's soluble and it is less dense than air. So how do you collect the gas? You have to choose upward delivery because it's less dense, and you cannot choose displacement of water because it's soluble. And you cannot pass this gas through any acidic material because it's basic, it will react with the acid. So this vocabulary of acid and base may be a bit too advanced now. We'll cover that in future chapters. And that is all for today. Hope you enjoyed this video. Give it a like and subscribe. Share it with somebody that needs to see this. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye.